Amazon Redshift Serverless makes it easy to run and scale analytics in seconds without the need to set up and manage data warehouse infrastructure. In this demo, we'll show you how to get started with Redshift Serverless and run some sample queries. Let's start by heading to the Amazon Redshift console and creating our serverless data warehouse. We could use the default settings for a quick and easy setup, but let's walk through customizing our own settings for this demo. First, we'll configure a namespace, which is a collection of database objects and users that groups together various storage-related objects like schemas, tables, and data encryption keys. We'll call it My Redshift Namespace. Next, we'll configure our admin user credentials. Let's leave the admin username alone, but check the box to have Redshift generate a secure password for us. We can also associate IAM roles to load and unload data or interact with related services like Amazon S3, CloudWatch Logs, SageMaker, or AWS Glue if needed. Finally, instead of using the default encryption keys, let's choose our own custom AWS KMS key. After configuring the namespace, we need to configure a workgroup, which we'll call My Redshift Workgroup. A workgroup is a collection of compute resources like RPUs, security groups, and VPC subnets, which we've also selected. Enhanced VPC routing forces Redshift to route all copy or unload traffic that goes between our cluster and data repositories through our VPC. We'll leave that setting turned off, as we won't be running any copy or unload commands in this demo. Finally, we'll click Save Configuration, and in just a few minutes, our serverless Redshift cluster is ready to go. Before we jump into our cluster and try out some queries, let's see how easy it is to set the base capacity for our cluster and improve the overall query performance. We just click on our workgroup name from the dashboard, switch to the Limits tab, then click Edit to change the base RPU capacity from the default of 128 to the new value of 200. Now, let's open the Redshift Query Editor v2 and run some queries. In the Query Editor, we can see the default dev database's public schema is empty. Let's open the sample data dev database and load the ticket sample data, which is used in most examples throughout the Amazon Redshift documentation. Finally, let's run the sales per event query, which will show us the total ticket sales for each event in descending order.